I'm Tyler. I work as an application engineer in the elevator group here at KEB America. Today, we'll be going through the benefits of using feed-forward torque control on the F5 elevator drive. The feed-forward torque controller reduces speed feedback coming back from the motor and instead relies on the system inertia to make a torque command prediction. Using this function results in exceptional ride quality and tight speed control. This function works well for both permanent magnet and induction geared applications. KEB's inverter programming software, Comnivis 6, will be used to show the benefits of using feed-forward torque control. Using the scoping feature, in our example, we have command speed in red, motor speed in blue, motor torque in green, and motor current in yellow. For information on connecting to Comnivis, please see the link in the description. Here in our elevator simulator, to show what a detuned motor system looks like, we will start out with an acceleration torque of 0 foot-pounds, meaning that the feed-forward torque control is turned off. What this scope shows us is that we have significant amounts of under and overshoot present within the system. Most important is this huge portion of overshoot going into constant speed, along with a little bit of instability within constant speed. This is also reflected in the torque. Notice how torque and current are the same. However, the current is simply the absolute value of the torque. This speed instability can be felt by passengers riding the elevator car. Now we're going to activate the feed-forward torque control on the elevator simulator using a previously learned acceleration torque value of 25 foot-pounds. With the feed-forward torque control active and a default gain setting of 90%, we have a much smoother speed profile. Under and overshoot have been eliminated within the profile, and our torque curve is much smoother, resulting in better ride quality for passengers. Comparing the scopes side by side, it's easy to see why using feed-forward torque control is beneficial. Without it active, we have under and overshoot within the profile. But with it active, we have minimized those areas of under and overshoot, resulting in better ride quality for passengers. For most applications, activating the feed-forward torque control and using default speed control gain settings are enough to provide good control with great ride quality. However, if more tuning is desired, the speed gain optimization function can be used. Rather than adjusting both the proportional and integral gain settings independently, the speed gain optimization function provides a range of values from 0 to 25 to control response. Values closer to 0 represent a softer profile, and closer to 25 represent a more aggressive profile. Typically, values between 8 and 12 work well for most applications. That's it for feed-forward torque control on the KEB F5 elevator drive. We hope this video helps you better adjust your elevator for improved ride quality.